Hello. In today's session, we are going to conduct types of fuel supply systems. Types of fuel supply systems. There are two types of fuel supply systems. Number one is air injection system, and number two is solid injection system. In air injection system, the fuel is injected under the pressure of air for supplying. High pressure air, multi-stage compressors are required, which are very much costly, and it required more space. Hence, this system is not in use nowadays. Another system is solid injection system. In this case, in the diesel engine, it is directly injecting the fuel by using fuel pump. In the combustion chamber, there are three types of solid injection systems. Number one, individual pump system. Number two, distributor system. Number three, common rail system. We'll see one by one. Number one, that is first type is air injection system. You can see in the figure various components of air injection system. There is multi-stage air compressor on the left side. So this multi-stage compressor, function of multi-stage compressor is to supply compressed air, pressurized air, which can carry the fuel. You can see the camshaft. The camshaft is operated by crankshaft. It is taking power from the engine. Camshaft is operating fuel pumps also. You can see there are separate fuel pumps for every cylinder. The fuel pump gets fuel from the fuel line, that is from the fuel tank, and function of fuel pump is to increase the pressure of fuel. And this pressurized fuel is supplied to high pressure fuel pump. And here at one side, air is coming in, and by other side, pressurized fuel from the fuel pump is entering at exact position, that is 15 degree before the TDC, and it is supplying fuel in the hot air. At the end of compression stroke, air is hot and air temperature is very high and pressure is also very high. In this high pressurized air and hot air, the fuel is sprayed in the fine particle and it is operated by mechanical linkage. When fuel is sprayed at high pressure in the fine particle, in hot air, the air temperature is more than the self-ignition temperature of the fuel. That's why fuel start burning. So in this figure, we can see that air injection system, there are two cylinders shown in the figure. Mechanical linkage is shown. This system is not in use nowadays because of multi-stage compressor. We'll see details of air injection system. In this method, fuel is forced into cylinder by means of compressed air to very high pressure. The rate of fuel admission can be controlled by varying the pressure of air. The fuel is metered and pumped to fuel valve by a camshaft driven fuel pump. Fuel valve is open by means of mechanical linkage operated by camshaft, which control the timing of injection. The fuel valve is also connected to high pressure air line fed by multi-stage compressor, which supplies air at pressure about 60 to 70 bar. We'll see some advantages and disadvantages of air injection system. air injection system provides better atomization and it distributes fuel properly. As a combustion is more complex, the brake mean effective pressure is higher. Inferior fuel can be used because of high pressure. Disadvantages. There are few disadvantages listed for the air injection system. It requires high pressure multi-stage compressor. This is the main disadvantage. A separate mechanical linkage is required to time the operation of fuel valve. Due to compression and linkage, the size of engine increases and it is very difficult to carry this complete system along with the multi-stage compressor. Since the fuel burn very near to the nozzle, it is overheating the nozzle and it reduces the life of nozzle. Next type is solid injection system. There are three types in the solid injection system: individual pump system, distributor system, common rail system. Atomization of fuel is done by either air blast or pressure spray. Solid injection system. Solid injection at about developing 100 to 200 pressure has reduced the need of having compressor. We'll see one by one. First is individual pump injection system. In individual pump injection system, we can see that there is individual pump and injector. Various components shown in the system are pump with an individual cylinder for each nozzle. The pump is, that is, fuel supply is controlled. Quantity of fuel supply is controlled by control rack. The pumps are operated by using camshaft. Individual pump as well as injectors we can see in the figures. So in the figure it is shown that there are four fuel injectors, means this is four cylinder engine. We'll see details about this individual pump injection system. In this system, each cylinder is provided with one pump and one injector, separate pump and separate injector. In high pressure pump, plunger is actuated by cam and produces fuel pressure necessary to open the injector valve at the correct time. That is, fuel pump is operated by cam and follower mechanism. The amount of fuel injected depends on effective stroke of the plunger. Disadvantage of this system. This system has to be designed accurately to pump small quantity of fuel. Second type, distributor system. In the distributor system, we can see various components. There is again cam and camshaft, primary pump, metering and pressure pump, control rod, distributor block, and nozzles, that is fuel injectors. So here, fuel pump is operated by using cam and follower mechanism. There are two pumps. Number one is primary pump, which increases the pressure at once, and in another pump, again it increases the pressure as per the requirement of engine. There is a control rack which can control the quantity of fuel to be supplied. Here we can see difference between individual system and distributor system is that in individual system, there were separate pump, fuel pumps for every combustion chamber or for every cylinder. But in the distributor system, here there is only one high pressure pump is used. This high pressure pump supply pressurized fuel to the distributor block. Distributor block holds the pressurized fuel and then it supplies to individual cylinder. We'll see details about this distributor system. The fuel pump, after metering the required amount of fuel, supplies it to rotating distributor. That is, high pressure pump supplies pressurized fuel to distributor block. Distributor block hold the pressurized fuel. If pressurized fuel is set, for example, if it is set at 200 bar pressure, so same 200 bar pressure is maintained in the distributor block. If it is more than that, that pressure is released by using relief valve, and always it is maintained to the set pressure. Again, another function of this distributor block, it is rotating, and as per the firing order, it is supplying correct quantity of fuel at correct time to each cylinder. Here, fuel pump is distributing fuel to the cylinder as per the correct firing order, which is operated by cam and follower mechanism. There is only one metering element. A uniform distributor is automatically maintained. It means that once the pressure is set and in the distributor block, it maintains constant pressure. So same pressurized fuel is supplied to each and every cylinder. So there is no pressure difference of fuel to supply various cylinders. Not only that, the cost of fuel injection system is also reduces to a wall less than 2/3 of the individual pump system, because cost of individual pump is very high. So by using this, we can reduce the cost and we can ensure that for every cylinder, same pressurized fuel is supplied as per the requirement as per the set firing order. Third system is that, so third system in the solid injection system, common rail injection system. In common rail fuel injection system, you can see that there is a fuel tank, then there is fuel filter, control high pressure pump with pressurely pump. There is high pressure pump. High pressure pump supplying fuel to the common rail. Then various sensors are used. This is advanced system. You can see the various sensors are provided in the common rail system. Rail pressure sensor, that is whether how much exact set pressure and how much pressure is available. It is sensed by using a rail pressure sensor. That at other end, pressure limiting valve means if the pressure is set at 1000 bar pressure, in that case, the exact set pressure is maintained in this common rail. This common rail is a common pipe in which pressurized fuel is stored or maintained. Then there is pressure limiting valve or pressure relief valve which maintain the required pressure. If pressure is more than the set, in that it release the fuel and maintain the constant pressure in the common rail. So from the common rail, fuel is supplied to individual cylinder by using fuel injectors as per the firing order. In the figure, it is shown that six fuel injectors means this is six cylinder engine, and various sensors are shown which gives input to the control unit, or it is ECU, electronic control unit. Various sensors you can see in the figure, that is engine speed, so it can be taken from the crankshaft, then engine phase camshaft, camshaft rotations, accelerator pedal, boost pressure, air temperature sensor, coolant temperature sensor, intake mass flow, how much intake mass flow is there. So all these components are there in the common rail injection system. A common rail injection system, how a single pump supplies high pressure fuel to header, a relief valve hold the pressure constant, the control wedge adjust the lift of mechanically operated valve to set the required amount of fuel and time of injection. We'll see how it is operating. So this pressurized high pressure fuel pump is taking fuel from the fuel tank. It is filtered before entering into the high pressure pump. This pressurized fuel is supplied to common rail. In the common rail, constant or set pressure is maintained. If it is more than that, it is relieved by using pressure limiting valve or pressure relief valve, and required high pressurized fuel is supplied at exact timing as per the firing order to each and every cylinder. Advantages of common rail injection system are: system is simple and there is less maintenance cost. Only one pump is sufficient for multi-cylinder engine. It fulfills requirement of either constant load or with variable speed, or variable load with constant speed. Variation in pump supply pressure affects all the cylinder equally. Disadvantages: leaks in the injection valve, accurate design and workmanship is required. Next point is types of fuel nozzles. So there are various types of fuel nozzles, that is single hole nozzle, multi hole nozzle, pintle nozzle and pintax nozzle. So we'll see one by one how these fuel nozzles are operating, what are their advantages and disadvantages. So first type is single hole nozzle. As you can see in the figure, this single hole, these nozzles are there in the fuel injector. The pressurized fuel, when it is entering from the fuel pump, it is entering at the bottom of fuel injector, and when in fuel injector is spraying fuel, pressurized fuel at right time to the combustion chamber of every cylinder. So how it is spraying, that pattern is there. So in this single hole, there is only one hole which is drilled at the center, and total fuel supply is through this single hole. So single hole nozzles are used in open combustion chamber type. At the center of nozzle body, there is a single hole which is closed by nozzle wall. The size of hole is usually larger than 0.2 millimeter. Hole may be drilled centrally or at an angle to the center line of nozzle. There are some disadvantages of this single hole system. Single hole nozzle has tendency to dribble. Dribble means Here the function of fuel injectors are, it has to supply pressurized fuel, and number two, it has to supply fuel which can convert it into atomized form when it is entering in the combustion chamber. Atomized form means in the gaseous form, and dribbling means when the liquid is not converted into gaseous form or atomized form, then it is called as, or when the liquid is present in the combustion chamber, that is called as dribbling. The spray angle is very narrow. You can see in the figure. This does not facilitate good mixing unless higher air velocities are provided. Next type is multi-hole nozzle. So to avoid the various disadvantages from the single hole system, the research has been done and it is converted into multi-hole system to overcome the disadvantages of single hole nozzle. You can see in the figure, in the multi-hole nozzle, number of holes are drilled at the bottom of fuel injector, and through these holes the fuel is sprayed in the combustion chamber. In order to mix the fuel properly, even with slow air movement available with many open chamber type combustion chambers, the number of holes varies. In the multi-hole nozzle are 4 to 18, and size is varying from 1.5 millimeter to 0.35 millimeter. When number of holes are increased, the diameter of hole is reduced. There are some advantages of this multi-hole type nozzle. It gives good atomization, distribute fuel properly even with lower air motion available in open combustion chamber. For combustion, it is getting very less time, and the function of fuel injector is that to spray fuel in the throughout combustion chamber so that this fuel can reach to each and every part of the combustion chamber where hot air is available. When this fuel is coming in contact with hot air, the burning or combustion process start, so that here the fuel velocity is playing very important role. When the fuel velocity, that is fuel movement from the fuel injector, is very high, in that case the combustion it is getting more time for the combustion, and combustion efficiency is increased. There are some disadvantages. There are chances of dribbling, very high injection, close tolerance and manufacturing is required. Hence, it is costly as compared to single hole type system. Next type, pintle nozzle. In order to avoid weak injection and dribbling, the spindle is provided with cylindrical and conical projection at the last end of spindle, you can see, and that projection is called as pintle, which protrude through the mouth of nozzle body. When walls start lifting, this pintle partially blocking the hole, and thus does not allow pressure drop to the greater extent. The spray cone by this spindle is up to 60 degree angle. We can see some advantages of this spindle nozzle. It is self-cleaning type because that projection is entering in the nozzle hole, in the nozzle. That's why it is cleaning the carbon. It prevents carbon deposition on the nozzle hole. When it is moving in and out, because of that, it is cleaning the carbon deposition on the nozzle hole, and it results in good atomization. Next and last type is Pintex nozzle. You can see in the figure, in the Pintex nozzle, there is auxiliary hole shown. This is the development over Pintel nozzle. So it is development of Pintel nozzle. That's why the spindle contain Pintel as well as another arrangement is auxiliary hole, and has an auxiliary hole drill in nozzle body. It helps in injection of small amount of fuel through it slightly before the main injection. At low engine speed, the needle wall does not lift. Most of the fuel is injected through this auxiliary hole. This resulting, which provides very good cold starting performance. At the cold starting or in the cold weather, when there is requirement of fuel supply, so this, because of low speed, the operation of pintle is less and it is not supplying the required fuel to the combustion chamber. In that case, fuel is supplied through this auxiliary hole and it is fulfilling the requirement of combustion to run the engine, and it is developing sufficient power, whatever the fuel supplied from the auxiliary hole. But so there are some disadvantages. The tendency of auxiliary hole to choke. The injection characteristics are even poor than multi-hole nozzle. As compared to multi-hole nozzle, injection characteristics are poor. These are some spray patterns shown. Various spray pattern, that is how fuel is flowing from the fuel injector. So we can observe that in single hole, it is flowing in a single pattern. But if it is used multi-hole system, that it is spread from the various nozzle or from the various holes in the combustion chamber, and in short span of time, it is covering the entire area of combustion chamber, with which helps to increase the combustion efficiency. These are some picture captured at the time of burning of fuel, and temperature distribution is shown in another figure. That is, in the first figure, how fuel is flowing and how burning is continued. In the next figure, temperature pattern is shown. So this is all about this session. So in today's session, we have covered different types of fuel injection system. There are mainly two types of fuel injection system. Number one is air injection system. Number two is solid injection system. So there are, or nowadays, we are not using air injection system because of requirement of multi-stage compressor for air injection. In solid injection system, there are three types. Number one, individual pump system. number 2 distributor system, number 3 common rail system. And we have discussed advantages, disadvantages of all these types. Again, there are different types of nozzles: single hole nozzle, multi hole nozzle, pintle nozzle, and pintex nozzle. These are the various types. We have also discussed about fuel spray pattern and temperature distribution after fuel supply. So this is all about today's lecture. Thank you. Thank you very much.